Hey everybody, how are you doing? Happy Tuesday. It totally feels like Monday here, and I'm realizing, oh my goodness, I'm leaving for Colorado in 2 days. Like it just totally jumped up without warning. Anyway, I hope everyone had a great Memorial Day weekend. What did you do for fun? I went to Connecticut with some good friends. We had a great time. But today I wanted to, and if you jump on live, just say hello. Tell me what's up, send some love. I just wanted to give you the top 10 reasons to join my free Embodiment and Body Reverence Challenge coming up this Monday, June 4th. Hi, Darren. This is going to be such, hi, Angela. Good to see you. This is going to be such a fun challenge. I love creating challenges in general because it's just such a fun sort of community-based, like actionable way to enact change. And for me, I just really enjoy the creative process and sharing some of the content that I have in this way because it's really just it's like bite-sized, but it's like really packs a punch and it's really actionable. And today I just wanted to share with you 10 reasons why you should join this particular challenge today, because I know there are a lot of challenges out there and they're super fun and it's hard to like determine which ones to do. But here are the reasons why you need to do this one. And the first reason is too many of us are living up here. We got our monkey minds, our heads are always racing, we're always distracted, we're always thinking about the next thing that's going to come next, the next thing we have to do. We're ruminating, we're processing things like at crazy levels of speed. And you know what happens when we're too much up here is that we forget to totally drop into our bodies and really just get the lay of the land. Like, how am I feeling? Where's their discomfort? Where am I feeling good? And so embodiment is like a really great way. And this has nothing to do, by the way, with, weight or size or age or anything like that. This is something that's applicable for every single person that we do well when we drop into our bodies, when we get that feedback, and we can really communicate on a deeper level with our bodies. So many amazing things can come from that. And it's not just about body image, but about just sort of feeling your best in your skin, no matter what your situation is. So that's number one is like, we live too much up here. We've got to drop into our bodies more and understand like the lay of the land. What's our bodies telling us? Number two is that when we're in our heads too much, we lose the capacity to hear and feel those subtle cues that our bodies give us day in and day out around hunger and satiety, our emotions, our complex emotions, about stress. Sometimes before I practiced embodiment, I wouldn't even realize that I was stressed, like until it was like at a like a fever pitch, you know what I mean? And now that I'm able to learn some of these techniques on how to become more embodied, I can feel the bubbles of stress coming up and I know how to handle it before it becomes a huge issue. That's number two. Number three, part of what heals our relationship with our bodies and our body image has to do with agreeing to be in our bodies in the first place. So a lot of us will only be in our, I'll only agree to be in this body when, I look a certain way, when I weigh a certain amount, when I fit in this particular size, when I move in this particular way, when I look in this at this, in this particular way. And it's really detrimental to our psyches because what we're not doing is agreeing to be in it no matter what, and I often say like body image isn't about loving your body, isn't it about like being totally in love with like every single thing in your body, like that's nothing to, well, I wouldn't say it's nothing to do with it, but you're not obligated to love your body. You're just obligated to be in it and to agree to be in it. And, suit through thick and thin, the good, bad, and ugly, when we're in pain, when we feel pleasure, and everything in between, because that's where we experience the full spectrum of what humans are capable of. But so many of us detach ourselves from that when we're not feeling comfortable, when we're not consistent with how we feel we should look like or what we should feel like. So I'm going to touch a lot about that in the challenge itself, but really it's just about agreeing to be in this body right here, right now, even if you don't love everything about it, even if it's not serving you in the way you want it to right now. And there's a real power in the acceptance piece and the ability to move from the appearance to the purpose. Like, what's the purpose of this arm? What's the purpose of my leg? And marveling in that and agreeing to be part of the whole experience. So that's number three. Number four is embodiment and body reverence. Oh, I actually said this before. It's not about falling in love with your body. It's about tuning into the purpose of each of your body parts and how it serves you every day. And my challenge is going to talk a lot about that, because when you do move from how it should look to how is it serving you and what are the ways that it does, there's something very deep about that. And it's a really great way to like shift your mindset about your body. So like I talk about this in interviews and so forth, but like for me, when I stopped to talk, you know, looking at my arm and just looking at the flaws and the flab and the whatever, when I started to see this arm is like, okay, why do I have this arm? It's so I can hold my children. It's so I can carry my groceries. It's so that I can do things. I can work. I can type. There are all these amazing things that I can do with this arm. And it doesn't serve me to just only focus on the way that it looks, because I'm missing this huge other piece of it. And when I was able to do that, it shifted me. It really created a paradigm shift about how grateful I am that my arm can do all these things and that I have this arm. So we're going to touch into that as well. Number five is that we really believe that we have to look a certain way, move a certain way, eat a certain way, and to be a certain age to truly feel good in our skin. But I'm here to tell you that that's not true. There are so many other powerful ways to feel alive and to feel good in the bodies that we have right now. And I want every person, man, woman, child, teenager, what have you, to really understand those ways, to move past the cultural ideals and the social construct that we've developed in our society that says you're only allowed to feel good if you look a certain way. You're only allowed to feel good if you fit into a certain size, or if you move a certain way, if you're a runner or whatever it is. And I really want to break apart that, and I really want to demystify that. Number six, embodiment. And this is a big one. Embodiment is the precursor to understanding how mindful eating works and to have a more empowered relationship with food. I'm really excited to share a lot more about that, but really it's the precursor. It's the first step in learning mindful eating is the embodiment. Number seven, tuning into our senses. So we have five powerful senses and other ways of communicating that we haven't even really tapped into yet. Like, because our perception is very narrow and we perceive the world through these five senses. That's not the only way, but that's the one that's visceral that we can really hang our hat on, so to speak. So this whole challenge is going to be about our five senses. And it's really cool because I'm going to be giving you songs and fragrances and little YouTube videos and recipes and things that are going to help you to tap into each and every one of those senses, whereby you can really start to understand how amazing your body can actually feel. Separate and apart from how it looks, from your age, from your size, and all of that, I'm going to help teach you how to utilize your five senses to really feel your best. Number eight, you're going to get to compete for daily prizes. These are really, really fun prizes. Again, they're all going to be based on the theme. And all you need to do is complete the assignments each day. They're going to be really simple, really actionable, super simple. Everybody can do them, and they're going to be really fun. And then you'll be entered in each day to win a prize like an iTunes gift card and my friend Kate Burns, her amazing food mood journal. I've got some other really good, fun prizes as well. And the grand prize winner is going to win a $1,500 prize. So this is sort of a no-brainer, right? You gotta join this. It's bit.ly/embodychallenge. bit.ly/embodychallenge. It's free to join. It's all going down in my Wellness Warriors Facebook group. You can join that. Everything's going to be there, but you need to register officially to win and compete for the prizes. Number nine is I'm going to be giving you a fun other goodies, like a daily affirmation, a gourmet recipe, fragrance suggestions, all that kind of good stuff. And the final reason, number 10, the best thing that you can do to get ready for summer is to raise the white flag on your body. So many of us are just looking at like doing this program, doing that program, losing 15 pounds, just so that you can earn the right to be in a bathing suit and to feel good in it. And that's not true. And so I want to have you raise that white flag on your bodies, not focus on the short-term aggressive weight loss strategy, which you've always done maybe, or that you've always sort of turned to when it becomes summertime. And maybe this time, maybe just this time, you do something different. You make a paradigm shift. You try something else, something that could be sustainable, something that could be loving, something that isn't aggressive to your body, but instead turning inward and, you know, really learning how to feel amazing in your skin. And I think what's most powerful about this is that you don't need to change a single thing about your body to feel good in it. And this is why you need to join this challenge. So I'm going to share that link one more time. Again, it's bit.ly/embodychallenge. It's in the link right here. Hi, whoever just joined. Jenna and Lisa, Tamara, Wendy, Kiana. Oh, I'm so glad you guys all are watching. Feel free to send me some likes and loves. Let me know that you're picking up what I'm putting down. But I can't wait to see you in the challenge. We start Monday, June 4th. Invite your friends, invite your family, invite your coworkers. This is a challenge that anybody can do. It's not just for like a particular type of person. It's anybody can benefit from this. And I will see you there. Again, we start Monday. Bye.